The National Center for the Study of Civil Rights and African American Culture at Alabama State University honors the charter members and activists of the Women's Political Council and the plaintiffs in the Browder versus Gale case, whose involvement in the protests against racial discrimination on city buses proved essential to the success of the Montgomery bus boycott. Whereas the Montgomery bus boycott was one of the most revolutionary struggles for freedom, justice, and equality in American history. And whereas this struggle led to an intensified period of agitation against the conditions which denied African Americans the rights of citizenship and respect offered others in the nation, called the modern civil rights movement. And whereas the arrest of Rosa Parks, former secretary of the local branch of the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People and longtime activist for Blacks' full constitutional rights, for refusing to sacrifice her bus seat to a white passenger on December 1, 1955, sparked 382 days of protest against the unjust and humiliating treatment African Americans received on municipal buses. And whereas 50,000 African Americans in Montgomery, Alabama, challenged racial inequality on city buses based on the philosophy and tactics of nonviolent resistance coupled with legal redress. And whereas city authorities, bus company officials, and white supremacist and terrorist organizations responded to Blacks' courage and commitment to principles underlying the movement for fair treatment of African Americans on local buses by attempts to intimidate boycott leaders and participants, and by efforts to divide the Black community. And whereas, led by the Montgomery Improvement Association, under the leadership of Martin Luther King Jr., Blacks proved their long-term devotion to the MIA's goals for the bus protests by serving on the MIA Executive Board. And whereas African-American women provided critical support for the MIA's plan to defeat discrimination on city buses, including attending mass meetings and serving in key positions in the MIA. And whereas the Women's Political Council, an organization promoting African Americans' rights as citizens, took a frontline position in the events leading to the bus protests. Founded in 1949 by Mary Fair Burks, chair of the Alabama State University's English Department, the organization under Burks' successor, Joanne Robinson, also an English professor at ASU, made racial bias on Jim Crow vehicles its chief concern. And whereas city officials' rejection of the WPC's plea for more humane treatment on municipal vehicles led the group to prepare for a boycott against Montgomery's transit systems. And whereas on the night of Rosa Parks' arrest, Robinson and two of her students printed thousands of flyers on ASU's campus calling for a one-day bus boycott. And whereas the bus boycott ended more than a year later with the Browder versus Gale decision overturning bus segregation. And whereas four activist-minded African-American women, including lead plaintiff Aurelia Browder, Susie McDonald, and teenagers Claudette Colvin, and Mary Louise Smith signed on as plaintiffs in the MIA's Browder versus Gale case. And whereas the plaintiffs endured severe and unfair pressure because of their decision to stand for justice and suffered years of negative consequences for putting aside personal welfare for the greater good. Be it therefore resolved that the National Center for the Study of Civil Rights and African American Culture at Alabama State University pays tribute to these and other individuals and organizations whose contributions to the crusade to end segregated bus service place them among the leaders of a generation of activists who planted the seeds of a new movement for justice and equality in American society, serving as a model for dealing with the divisive social issues facing the nation in the 21st century.
Thank you.